I'm coming back for good, so let them niggas know it's mine. Hey guys, so I wanted to come on here and make a video about the metallic gold liquid latex barrier that I posted up on my Instagram. You guys, seriously, all that it is this, okay? I got this off of Amazon. I believe it was $30, 35 tops. I don't know if you can read that, but that's 32 ounces, okay? 32 ounces. This was at most $35, okay? Now, what I did was I also bought some of these. This was $6 or $3 for six of them, okay? Which is very cheap. It has the ball inside. I also bought this pack of holographic glitter, okay? It came with a gold one. This was maybe 99 cents. It's just a little sample pack. It was 99 cents at the most. And I had one of these syringes just laying around the house from a medicine little dispenser for my kids. You can get these also at CVS or Walgreens for a dollar, anywhere from $1 to $3. Now, I suctioned out what I needed with this, and I put it in a little bowl with some glitter, mixed it up really, really well, suctioned it back out, and then put it in a nail polish bottle. Okay, now if you guys know anything about these cuticle barriers, liquid latex, cuticle protectors, whatever you want to call them, I mean, they range anywhere from $10 to $20 for one of these bottles. Now, let me just help you guys out in here so you don't have to do the math yourself, but one of these bottles is 15 milliliters. Yeah, there's 30 milliliters in 1 ounce. 32 ounces in this. So if you do the math for no more than $40, okay, I got 64 of these little bottles. 64 of these little bottles for no more than $40 when most people are paying $15 to $20 for one of them. Like, that's crazy. Now, I also did the math on how much that cost for each one of these, and it came out to 63 cents for each one of these. Now, if you don't want to spend like the whole $40 at once, this company that makes this liquid latex, I mean, they have, first of all different colors. I mean, you can get purple, green, blue, yellow, I mean, literally silver, white, any color. You can get flesh tone, like Simply Peel. Yeah. You can get any color that you can think of. I mean, I'm sure everyone knows where to get some holographic glitter, but they also have a smaller size. I believe it is, I'm not even going to say it. I know it's basically half of this size, so it's more than likely about 16 ounces. It's about half of the big one for much cheaper. I think it's like $5 or $6. It's not half, I lied. It's probably like 5 to 10 ounces, and it's maybe only $5. So you can spend a lot less money, you know, and still be getting like the same product and, you know, not have to dish out as much money at once. But, I mean, when you spend more money, you buy in bulk, you save money in the long run. So, I pretty much never have to buy a liquid latex barrier again in my life. I mean, this is going to last me my entire life, and it works really, really well. I'm actually going to put a clip up, next, and you guys will be able to see how well this actually works. I'm going to do it a little gradient, which is probably the messiest thing you can do besides a water marble, and you guys will see just how good this works. It really does work, so don't think that, oh, I'm spending less money, so, you know, it must be a lot cheaper or whatever. That is not the case. This stuff works probably better. I mean, this stuff works just as good, if not better, than these $10 to $20 bottles of this stuff that are on the market right now. I'm not trying to throw shade at any companies. I'm just trying to be real with you guys. I purchased this, okay? This is the Queen Liquid Latex Barrier. This stuff is shit. It sucks so bad. I hate this so much. I also have purchased Simply Peel in the past. I do like Simply Peel just as much other people do, but I mean, these people are literally paying 60 cents to make this stuff. It is the same thing as this. I don't care what anyone tells you. It is the same exact thing, okay? And these people are paying 60 cents and they're charging $10 to $15 for a little bottle of Simply Peel. So, guys, make it yourself, okay? Don't go spending that type of money. It's so simple. Most of these things that I bought were for Prime eligible, so shipping is free. And it comes in 2 days. You cannot beat that, okay? You just can't beat that. Now, I mean, I can say anything I want about this stuff, but, you know, you need to see it to believe it. So, you know, right now I'm going to put a little clip in of me using it. And I'll see you in the next video, guys. Bye. Okay, guys, so the first thing that we're going to do, I'm just going to do a whole gradient and show you guys how the liquid latex barrier works. So the first thing that I'm going to do is put on my base coat. I actually use two base coats. I like the OPI Natural Nail Base Coat. This really does prevent staining on my nails. I've never had another base coat that genuinely, like, prevents staining. Okay? So what we're going to do is we are going to get this on our nail. Alright, and we're going to wait for that to dry. Once that dries, the next base coat that I like to use is Unt Ready for Takeoff. It is actually a peel-off base coat. It is my favorite peel-off base coat. If you guys want me to do a review on it, I can. You know, I tend to not keep on my polish for too long. So I do like it when, you know, I can just peel it off so I don't have to use so much acetone. Alright, so this is basically dry. That was very quick. And this is what the Unt Ready for Takeoff base coat looks like. It's not one of those Elmer's glue-ish peel-off base coats. It's clear, and it is the best. I absolutely love this stuff. Alright, let me frame up. And let's get this on. Alright, and now we're going to wait for that to dry. Now, the first thing I forgot to mention, first thing that I always do before I start painting my nails, I always put acetone or some type of alcohol on my nails to get rid of all the natural oils. Alright, so if you see this little nail over here all dried out, it is not because my nails are unhealthy or dry. It is because I did just put acetone on them, so that's kind of what happens. So now this is dry. This is nice and dry. So next thing that you want to do is put down your base color layer. You want it to either be one of the colors that you're going to do your gradient with, or you want it to be white or like a beige color. I'm using a polish by Essie. I think this is a beautiful, like, it's coming off a little bit more of like a blue on camera, but this is actually like a turquoise color. This is called Garden Variety from Essie. So we are going to shake that up, and we are going to get that painted on. You don't need a thick layer of this or anything, okay? It's just the bottom layer. And if I could actually paint my nails, this would be much better. So I am going to take my favorite cleanup brush in the entire world. I actually just bought all of Twinkle T's brushes, and they're fabulous. This is the number 2. This is the smaller one. I tend to use this one when I have like a really small area where I really need to get in close to that cuticle. I will use this brush. This is actually what the head looks like. It is very, that is how it
is not focusing. There we go. It is very small and very cute, and it's perfect for getting right in there. All right, so we're just gonna get a little bit of cleanup going on here. Like that, okay? All right, so the next thing you wanna do is take your liquid latex. Of course, you guys know what mine looks like. And we are going to get this all on the cuticle. Now, this stuff has very easy application. And it also dries really fast. So I love it. So let's get this on. So we're gonna let this dry. All right, I'm gonna say that by the time we're done painting our sponge, that this will be ready. So the next step that you're gonna do is you're gonna get your colors that you are gonna do your gradient with. The three that I'm using, again, this is what I did my base color with. It is SC, Garden Variety, and then I'm also going to use SC. This is called Jamaica Me Crazy. So pretty. And then we are also going to use SC. This is called Lots of Lux. So you're gonna give these a little shake and you're gonna get them open. And then you're gonna take your little sponge, okay? We got our sponge. And then what you're gonna do is start painting little. If you have longer nails, you can do your stripes a little longer. If you have shorter nails like me, you want to keep them, you know, kind of close together, and you want to overlap them. It will help with the blending process later. Now we're going to do a couple coats of this. So, you know, your first coat's not going to be perfect. There we go. There's our first coat. Then you're going to take your sponge. Okay, so you're going to do it again. I didn't really realize how pretty these colors were together, but they are beautiful. Do the same thing one more time. This a little bit more. And there we go, guys. There's our gradient. Now this is the fun part. You're gonna take a pair of tweezers and you want to go in and grab this, okay, and give it a nice peel. Bam. Now we have minor cleanup. So next you're gonna wanna take your cleanup brush and you are going to clean up the edges. Now, from Twinkle Tea, I showed you guys the number 2 brush. I also have number 12, so I'm gonna kind of use that for along the outside of my nail. I know it's not perfect, but. Now what you want to do is take a quick dry top coat. Oh. And we are, and there we go, guys. And we're done. So, I hope that really showed you the latex and, you know, convinced you to stop paying $20 for one bottle. If you guys have any questions, feel free to leave a comment down below, subscribe, and like this video if you enjoyed this. All right.